Hi, it's Dr. Ron England here, and today's little lecture is on really one of the basics of JavaScript. And what I'm showing you up here on screen is a JS fiddle, and we're going to talk a little bit about arrays. And the beauty of arrays is they are relatively straightforward and simple. So first thing I'm going to do is I'll show you a little chunk of code here. First, I've got this nice little form here in my JS fiddle. And I have this where it says add array item, so I'm going to put A in there and hit go. And then I've got where it says element A added at index 0. And now I'm going to add a second one, B. I hit go. And it's going to say element B added at index 1. That's as far as I'm going to go with that. And now I'm going to hit this button that says show. And it's going to put a little rule here. And item 0 equals A, item 1 equals B. That's what I'm going to show you. Now, this is really just to show you how the arrays work. But first, we'll look a little bit at the code, the HTML code first. I have an input text field. I have two buttons. One calls add to array, the other one calls print array. And then I've got a div called output. And the output is where I put that last little chunk of item 0 equals A, item 1 equals B. Now, let's talk a little bit about arrays here. Arrays are sets, or what we call collections of something. Now, remember, in JavaScript, everything is an object. So, in JavaScript, an array is a collection of objects. And collections are generic things. Now, an array is a specific type of a collection. An array is a specific type of a collection that is integer index, meaning you can index it and actually reference it by an integer index, something that lets you find what that element in the array is. So right here at the very top, okay, and I'll point out one thing in this JS fiddle, I'm not using any libraries, and I'm basically the JavaScript is going to be, when I put no wrap in header, what that means is it's going to go ahead and put that JavaScript in the head section of my HTML. So, I've got two variable declarations. One is I and one is array. Now, the reason I've got two variable declarations here is because I want to demonstrate to you how that indexing works. Now, I don't really need that variable I because I could do it using the length of the array, but I'm going to demonstrate that too. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to have this function that says add to array. Now, to add to the array, I first get the contents of the text box. I do that by using the document object, this function getElementById, and the ID of the text box is text1.value, and I set that equal to array of I. Now, notice that that is inside the function, and this is outside the function. What this means is these variables have global scope. I can use them inside the functions. That's important because I used this variable I, and I declared I outside of a function, and I usually like to use I for for loops inside a function, and that can cause me a naming collision. Okay, in other words, I can exist in both places. Now, there are scoping rules to deal with that. Scope, very important. Scope is where those variables can be seen. Okay, when you declare a variable inside of a function, it's only got scope inside the function. It doesn't have global scope. These two, however, have global scope. So I have this variable I, which you can see is 0, which means it's an integer, and I have this variable called array, which is equal to new array, which means it's an array. So I've declared an array. I gave you that little alert message that said element array of I is added at index I. So in other words, I've added something at that index. And then what I do is I increment I, and remember I is global, so I is going to go from 0 now to 1, and I go ahead, in this case, I set the value that's inside that text box to be an empty string, because you know what, I'm going to enter another one. Okay, and that's what actually happens when I click the button go, which calls the function add to array. Okay, the next one that I have here is called print array. And in print array, and that's what happens if I click the show button, and I can come over here and you can see what actually gets printed out. So I create a variable s, which I set to an hr. Well, that's that line that you see right there. And then I've got a loop. I set j equal to 0. I increment j up to the length of the array. Length is a property of the array, how long it is. And then I increment j, so I'm going to do this loop. And all I do is I add to the string s plus equals, so basically I'm going to add to the string item j, that's the index, is equal to array sub j, and then I put a hard a line break in there to come back out. And I go ahead and set the inner HTML of my output, which is the div that I had there, equal to s, which is the string that I just created. So let's go back one more time. You've looked at the code now. We can come back and let's go ahead and rerun this. Okay, so I can say add item arrays go. There, arrays is added at 0. R, whoops, go, easy, go. And I hit show, and now I've got item 0, arrays are easy. That pretty much should help you through getting through the basics of working with an array. There's a lot more that you can do with an array, and something that you've got to keep a real eye on is that in JavaScript, everything is an object. An array does not have to have, and each individual index of that array does not need to be the same type of object. That's good, and that can be bad. Okay, if everything needed to be included as the same type of object, we would say that this is strongly typed. It is not strongly typed, it is weakly typed. Okay, in other words, you can have anything. Actually, there's no typing requirements whatsoever. When you create an array, you can have a function as one element of the array, and the values that are going to be passed to the function as the next element in the array. There's all sorts of things you can do with an array. So you can, as you start working with them, you'll find that they're extremely powerful and great capability. Thank you very much, and good programming. I hope you got a lot out of this straightforward lecture on arrays.